चेतन चरितामृत टेक्स्ट 5.62। तुम्हारा सकल लोक करह विचारे, मोर पितार कन्या दीते योग्य की इहारे। एल्डर ब्राह्मण सन इज काउंटरिंग द पॉइंट्स विच द यंगर ब्राह्मण इज मेकिंग, एंड ही आफ्टर असैसिनेटिंग द कैरेक्टर ऑफ द यंगर ब्राह्मण, नाउ ही इज चैलेंजिंग the younger brahmana by saying, tomara sakala loka, all of you people karah vichare, just think, do mora pitara kanya, that my father's daughter, that means my sister, dite yogya ki hare, do you think he is qualified to marry my sister? He is trying to draw, he doesn't use the word mora bhagni, he has used the word bhagni earlier, now he is using pitara kanya. His father was a respected elder citizen in the village, and they all knew about his elevated status, so therefore he's trying to draw on that status, and he's saying mora pitara kanya, that do you think that the daughter of such an exalted person can marry a man like him? So he's trying to in this way play on the sectarian prejudices of people and make them biased against this younger brahmana.
Chaitanya Charitamrit Madhya Leela chapter 5 text 63. Itashuni loker mane haila samshay, sambhave dhana lobhe loka chhade dharma bhay. So the pastime of the brahmana is going on over here. The two brahmanas who have actually committed to taking in who have arrived at agreement to have their daughter. Elder brahmana had promised that the younger brahmana would get his daughter in marriage, but the older brahmana, under pressure of the family members, is rescinded from the promise. And at that time, the younger brahmana is now taken the matter to court. He's taken the matter to the court. So when he's taken the matter to the court was not a formal court in terms of people being there being official judge. The court was more a matter of informal assembly of people, and in that assembly the elder brahmana says that I don't remember, and the elder brahmana's son says that actually this person has cheated us, so he has cheated my father and has given him intoxication, made him mad and stolen all his money. So Itashuni, on hearing all this, lokera man haila samshay, on hearing this people became doubtful. Sambhave dhana lobhe loka chhade dharma bhay. Sambhave, he thought it's possible that dhana lobhe, out of greed for money, loka chhade dharma bhay, people will give up dharma bhay, fear in giving up religious principles. Normally speaking, the highest level of God realizing, the highest level of approaching it, God, is love for God. But even before love for God, there is fear of God, and fear of God is also healthy. So dharma bhay. So actually, the fear that if I give up my dharma, then there will be consequences. I should not give up my dharma. That is a healthy fear. But unfortunately, that fear is given up. Just as a person may, thief may give fear of law, because a thief feels that I can get away without it. I will be able to get away without it. And when the person feels like that, at that time the person recklessly asks recklessly gives up violates dharma. So the people decided to people started feeling doubt. So then this younger brahmana speaks na, tabe chota vipra kahe shuna mahajan nyaya chini bare kahe asatya vachan. So tabe chota vipra kahe, so on hearing this the younger vipra said, shuna mahajan, oh mahajanas, please hear. Now we may use the word mahajan in a technical sense to refer to the 12 mahajanas who are talked about in the Bhagavatam, but that is not the only sense in which the word can be used. The word can also be used in a generic sense to refer to anyone who is a great person. It means who is a, so Mahajan is a general term of address of respect. And with that general address of respect, what happens? Shuna Mahajan. This elder brahmanas, younger brahmanas spoke to all the other people respectfully. So we see the cultured, respectful attitude of the younger brahmana and all that is happening over here. And as he says, respecting them addressively, Nyaya jini bare kahe. That just to get the decision on his side, just to win the argument. Now we may use the word nyay in a conversational sense. So the word nyay may mean nyay also means justice, but nyay in the philosophical sense refers to argumentation. Nyay is one of the six systems of philosophy, and which focuses a lot on argumentation. Making logical arguments, and nyaya is generally used also in the sense of arguments. So nyaya jini mare, here nyaya doesn't mean justice, here nyaya means argument. So to win jini bare, to win an argument, kahe asatya vachan, he is speaking untrue words, asatya vachan. So now he has been accused of falsity, and it's like a strong character assassination that is being done to the younger brahmana. But the younger brahmana is speaking the truth in a very respectful way. So 65th verse, ei vipramora sevaye tushtaya behaila tore ami kanya deep apane kahila. So ei vipramora sevaye, so this elder brahmana, when I served him, he became satisfied. Tushtaya behaila, he became satisfied. And when he became satisfied, tore ami kanya diva apane kahila, apane, on his own he said that I will give you my daughter in marriage. So it was not that I deceived him, it was not that I forced him. He's saying apane kahila, he spoke this on his own, and it was not because I gave him any intoxicating or anything like that. It was he spoke on his own, and remember, okay, there is such a difference in the caste. And there is a level of caste and level of families. So why would he speak such a thing? He says, he spoke because mora sevaye tushta. He was satisfied by my service, and that's why he spoke like this. So then, 66th verse, tabe muni nishedhinu shunadvi javar tomara kanyara yokya nahi muivar. So he says that actually when he himself spoke like this, I opposed him. He's actually giving a, younger brahmana is giving a truthful narrative of what had happened. And he says, tabhi mune nishidhinu, nishedh. Nishedh means to forbid something. So he says, I forbade him. Shuna dvijavar. And I told him, Shuna, oh here, dvijavar, oh greatest among brahmanas, best among brahmanas, tomara kanyara yogya nahi muivar, that I am not fit to be a bride for your daughter. Tomara kanyara yogya, that to be not eligible to as a husband for your daughter. Now the younger brahmana is practically taking the wings out of the sail of the elder brahmana's son's assault. The elder brahmana has criticized, saying that, do you think this fellow is qualified to be my sister's husband? You know, he is like a dwarf desiring to reach the moon. He was obviously referring to the fact that the younger brahmana was from a relatively lower caste, was from a relatively a poorer family. So he's saying that, yeah, am I overstepping? He says, I myself knew that it is inappropriate, and that's why I told him, I forbade him, I requested, desisted, and I told him to desist from it. He says, I am not qualified. So we see that when we are criticized, rather than becoming defensive or aggressive, we can focus on being assertive. You know, that means if we become aggressive, that means we attack the character of that other person. If we become defensive, that means that we feel as if I'm right. So either reaction is undesirable, because in both cases we are driven by too much by emotions. We want to prove our rightness in when we are too defensive, or we want to prove the other's wrongness when we are too aggressive. But rather than doing either of that, if we focus on being assertive, that means we stay humble, but we stick to the truth and present the truth in a humble, objective, non-judgmental way. So in that way, we can make sure that people don't get alienated from us, and whatever value judgments that people may have about us, the effect of that in judging the specific issue that is in front of us, that can be minimized. So here, the younger Brahmana stays respectful towards the people in general by saying that you are Mahajan. He says respectful to the elder Brahmana by referring to him as Vipravar, and he reveals humility by saying that, you know, I knew that I was not qualified. So in this way, we'll see how he opens the minds of the people towards him by his very cultured, non-aggressive, non-defensive behavior. We'll continue this in our next talk. Thank you.